Track 20. Concentration camp cut set. Liberated, 21 February 1941. Witold's French and translation.
On 21st February 1941, the birthday anniversary of my mother Maria, and exactly 1 week after that day when I was slapped on my face for having dreamt about my freedom, I found myself at 6 o'clock in the morning at roll call. My predisposition was no different than in the past week. Standing there, insensible, indifferent, shriveled up from cold, I heard announcements made in German. Naturally, my Polish co-prisoners, standing in my row, started engaging me to listen to this announcement. As it appeared, my number 27578 was being called out. Being too numb, I have not heard it calling. Our block chief was a husky guy, approached me and brawled, with full throat raging at me. But he yelled always in this way, having a distinction of a man who has never done any harm to anybody, and this was also in my case. We were called out all four, two originating from Poland and two from Germany. We were immediately isolated from the others. As I wrote already before, we were fearful, was this not a similar case to the other four prisoners described before, where the four were shot afterwards? Luckily, after the roll call, they conducted us to take a bath and afterwards to the infirmary to see a doctor who verified if any of us was not scarred with compromising signs of beatings or torture. After that, we received a haircut. We received back our clothing that was stored in a vault. I must admit with admiration that my set of clothing, my hat, my umbrella were cleaned and ironed very diligently, and all accessories that were originally in my pockets were there. All my valuables were also stored in a vault and they have been returned to me. For example, they have returned to me my golden watch, my marriage ring, and my money. In a special travel office, they have issued to us train tickets for express trains, in my case to Warsaw. Leaving this office, one Pole has not closed the door behind him. Following the principle, one for all for one, we have been punished. We were ordered to leave and align up facing the office window, heads off at attention during 1 hour. I may add that we have been arrested in the summer, having only our summer clothing. Since we were in February and the temperature was minus 10 degrees Celsius, you can imagine how dangerous was this for our heads. All the more that we were facing the office windows and we could not even move to warm ourselves up. After that expiation punishment, we have received in another office a certificate stating that we have underwent our condemnation and that we obtained our freedom. 1 hour ago, being only a pack animal, at once I read in my just obtained certificate, herewith we confirm that Mr. Diplom Engineer Witold Miller from, to, resided in the Sachsenhausen concentration camp, and as a result of an exemplary behavior was released on 21st February of 1941. A constable guided us to the office of the camp commander, where the commander in person preached himself during 10 minutes about our return to society. The same constable escorted us to the gate, where another SS soldier verified our certificate. And from that moment on, we were left to ourselves. We were left completely free. The fight against cold, hunger, loneliness, and death during our stay in the camp was over.
Et dès ce moment, nous fûmes laissés à nous-mêmes. Et donc, nous étions complètement enfin libres. La lutte contre le froid, l'hiver, la mort, la solitude pendant le séjour au camp furent finies.
French.
Nous de Pologne, nous nous sommes rendus à la gare d'Oranienburg où, attendant notre train pour Berlin, chacun de nous mangea deux dîners, dit un topsgericht.
In translation.
We both from Poland proceeded to the Oranienburg station, where awaiting our train to Berlin, each of us had two portions of the German Eintopf dinner. In Berlin, we both walked the streets of that city. In a cafe, we drank double coffees with a multitude of pastries. Next, I have visited alone the main Unter den Linden Street, and others. I recall that the St. Hedwig Cathedral was enclosed by a fence since it has been bombed out by the Allies. In one of the department stores of the Karlstrasse, I ate a soup. In a restaurant on the Friedrichstrasse, I was that busy eating that I have not realized that it became already dusk. In general, Berlin was kept to that degree on the lights out that I had a difficulty finding my Friedrichstrasse station, which I was helped by a passing soldier. When I arrived there, I had another meal.